Today in the news, we've got some primo AMD Computex coverage. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Alright, so I'm pretty pissed and at the same time quite relieved about AMD's lineup at Computex. I mean, this could have gone so much worse. My expectations varied quite a lot throughout the last month. In fact, one thing that I had mentioned a few months ago was that AMD did not need a 16-core part, even though it was something I wanted. I just thought that if the single-core performance was good enough to beat whatever Intel had, AMD could stick to a 12-core CPU as their flagship to keep the 16-core for next year's lineup, or just as a surprise in case Intel comes up with something new. Well, it looks like this is kind of what AMD did, although stick to the end for some more information on that. Today, they unveiled their 3rd-gen 7-nanometer Ryzen CPUs, and here are the details. First, we have the Zen 2 core. AMD managed to get a 15% IPC improvement with double the cache and 2x the floating point performance. That is pretty amazing. After talking about Zen 2 for a while, they showed us their new line of CPUs. First, with the Ryzen 7, we have the R7-3700X. This CPU will have 8 cores and 16 threads, have a base clock of 3.6 GHz, and a boost of 4.4. This in itself is pretty disappointing, since clocks have definitely not improved as much as we thought. But thanks to the incredible 15% IPC uplift and the 18% improvement in multi-thread workloads, this CPU absolutely destroyed the 9700K from Intel. The 3700X completed the Cinebench R20 benchmark 33% faster than the 9700K. Impressive, but it's a little weird that we haven't seen it pitted against the 9900K. At least the price is definitely appealing at a low $329 for this 8-core CPU. The 9700K averages $400 US or 500 Canadian, so this is truly a no-brainer at that price. Then we had the 3800X, which goes a little further with a boost clock of 4.5 GHz this time. Once again, clockwise, not too much of an improvement, but the rest of the improvements definitely make up for it. I mean, 36 megabytes of cache, that's huge. This CPU does bring the price up quite a bit though at $399 US. But then we got the one more thing moment we were waiting for at the end of the presentation.
Now, I do have one more thing for you this morning. Do I have one more thing?
The brand new class of Ryzen CPUs, the Ryzen 9s. Yep, that's a thing now, and as you might have noticed, the Ryzen 7 didn't feature any 12 cores like the leak said, so what about the 9s? Well, that's where we have the new flagship Ryzen 9 3900X. This new name was not featured in any of the leaks, and it is the one with the highest core count we have so far. This CPU will sport 12 cores and 24 threads, 70 megabytes of cache, and will have a base clock of 3.6 GHz with a boost of 4.6, much higher than the 12-core engineering sample that we've seen so far at 3.6 GHz, but still shy of the coveted 5 GHz everyone was talking about. Still, they ran a Blender demo of the 3900X against the 9920X from Intel, a 12-core monster CPU that costs $1,200, and the R9-3900X was about 18% faster than the Intel part. Now that's what I call beating the competition, especially at its price. Lisa seemed quite excited about it.
That's half the price! That's half the price of our competition with much, much more performance.
One.
Yep. $499 for a 12-core CPU that beats a $1,200 one. All of those CPUs will be available on July 7th. Now, what about the 16-core? We haven't heard anything about it during Computex. Well, Gamers Nexus had some exclusive information about Ryzen and received confirmation of the existence of the 16-core CPU. Now, we don't have explicit specs, but Steve did mention that overclocked, this CPU can pull up to 300 watts on air. That's a lot, but it is a 16-core CPU after all. In terms of other Ryzen CPUs and specs, we'll have to wait until E3 to get more information. So after this event, was I disappointed? Not really. Did I get myself way too hyped up about the possibility of a 16-core CPU showing up at Computex? Sure, but honestly, the lineup looks golden for AMD right now. And the upgrade path seems legit for anyone looking to upgrade their system. AMD did not disappoint, the leaks did. Anyways guys, that is pretty much it for the news. I expect I'm gonna stay up all night to edit that one, and right after I'll have to edit the one for Navi too, so consider dropping me a like. You can click right here to see the Navi coverage at Computex. That is some pretty juicy stuff right there, and right there to subscribe to the channel. Stay frosty my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one. Seriously, I'm gonna stay up literally all night.